Today I'm going to talk to you guys about dirt. Although the dirt we walk on is only a 1 meter thin layer of the Earth's crust, all living things depend on that layer to survive. The soil is our reservoir for storing and moving all the nutrients, liquids, and gases needed for life. While we have depended on soil since the beginning of civilization, we still know surprisingly little about it. For example, few can tell us what exactly soil is. We know that good soil looks and feels like this dark brown, spongy cake that smells fresh. But the exact composition of that cake is still a mystery. After all, a single teaspoon of soil contains more distinct microbes in it than all the humans on planet Earth. So it's a really complicated substance. Another basic thing that we don't know is what's called the soil nutrient budget. Underneath our feet, what is the current level of acidity, carbon, nitrogen, and other nutrients? We need to know that because whenever you grow food, you extract these nutrients from the soil as a kind of price that you have to pay. And if we're gonna pay back our debt, we need to put those nutrients back into the soil somehow. Unless you keep the nutrient budget balanced, farmers are not gonna be able to continue producing the food that we eat. Over time, I realized the true value of soil. So I decided to build my own tech company named QED. We focus on Africa because the future of Africa's food security depends crucially on its agricultural growth. And we know that Africa's soils are also suffering the most right now from widespread nutrient depletion and from erosion. That's why the Africa Soil Information Service was created back in 2009 to develop clever strategies to collect data about the soils of Africa. We definitely can't say that we solved this problem, but I just want to share a simplified story about what QED has done so far. It's really expensive to collect soil, and so you only want to collect soil measurements in places that actually matter to farmers, where you have some croplands and you have some houses. If you want to find those kinds of places efficiently, we built an app called GeoSurvey, and this is a crowdsourcing software for analyzing satellite imagery. Users are shown random maps of the Earth, and they can trace all the croplands and the houses. We trained the computer with enough examples to do this for us. So thanks to millions of submissions sent to GeoSurvey, we can see the computer automatically marking up entire countries. Armed with these kinds of maps, now we have a strategic game plan for places that our field teams should target to most efficiently collect the soil. Traditionally, soil scientists use a process that's called wet chemistry. And if you're running a national survey, that can easily cost you millions of dollars to do. So to make this more affordable, we use infrared spectrometers, which are 10 times cheaper and only run on the cost of electricity. What they do is they shine infrared light on the soil, and then by measuring the reflections of that light, surprisingly, we can predict certain nutrients quite well. The increased affordability of this kind of method allows us to collect much more data than previously available. We need governments to take a renewed interest in soil. Most of the world's poorest people are employed in agriculture. Their whole livelihood hinges on the fertility of that soil. And they do the best they can with the tools that they have, but these farmers can't control changes to their entire landscape or what kinds of fertilizers they can access. But if we use soil data, governments can design soil conservation efforts. They can guide the private sector to develop the right fertilizers for improving farmer yields and farmer incomes. If we want to build really high accuracy maps of soil and plant health, we're going to need a lot more data. And that's going to require serious moonshot innovation. So first of all, it's really expensive right now to be collecting soil samples, shipping them from the field to the lab. And secondly, while the instruments we've been using are cheaper than before, they're still a bit too expensive and delicate for many rural and remote areas. If we're gonna move forward, I suggest we channel this punk science movement to develop low-cost, handheld sensors that can get everybody involved with science. This thing is made from components that you guys all know about. PVC pipes, I got a razor blade in here, AA batteries, Raspberry Pi, DVDs for diffraction gratings, and of course, you've all got this supercomputer sitting in your pocket, which interfaces to produce an instant spectrogram. I challenge the next generation to do better than us and make us even cheaper and more scalable to collect data at scale. As a child, I dreamed about being an astronaut, so I studied things like physics, and later, actually worked on telecommunications at NASA. Nothing in my life up to this point ever suggested that I'd be talking about dirt. But over time, I realized that there's actually no need to leave this planet, because one of the greatest mysteries of this universe is literally right underneath your feet.